TWI has been helping an illustrious neighbour to Abingdon, the Imperial War Museum at Duxford. As part of a restoration programme to breathe new life into this Second World War Mustang, TWI was asked to recreate resistance welds first used 60 years ago. Martin Espin from the Fighter Collection takes up the story.
At some point in this aeroplane's life, the lower section of this firewall had been replaced with a part that really filled the hole rather than actually had any structural integrity. In restoring this aeroplane, we've obviously looked at all the items of the aeroplane that are not particularly suitable for reuse, and this was just one of several items that were found. This area is a junction, if you like, of several major attachment points for the fuselage and for the wing. The piece that was in there was actually missing two out of three important attachments. So we've actually replicated the whole panel to be sure that we have all of the original attachment points intact. We were unable to find a Civil Aviation Authority approved company with the capability to weld, resistance weld, this thickness of material. That was the biggest issue. The TWI involvement is a company with the capability to carry out the type of quality welding that we require on this panel. It's a structural piece of the aeroplane. We have original microfilm drawings of the panel itself and all the structural components that are attached to it. What we didn't have was a definitive quality for the welding itself. It just uses the words, you know, resistant spot welding. We've had to go back to the drawing board, as it were, to find out a quality to use nowadays, a more modern equivalent. We were able to determine that it was a type 321 stainless that had been used. And from that information, we were able to determine that the modern equivalent is an AMS specification 5516. We are a little way behind with the project, but hopefully at the end of this year we'll see this aeroplane in the air.
Martin Espin,